Jesteśmy w biurze Tickmill w Limassol na Cyprze, gdzie mamy przyjemność spotkać Illimara Mattusa, jednego z założycieli Tickmill. Hello, Illimar. How are you doing?
I'm very good, thank you. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you too. It's great you found time to give us this interview. Please tell me, Tickmill has grown massively over the last couple of years. It's a very big success. I hear good feedback from traders in Poland about your company. And please tell me, how do you see it? What are key factors behind your success?
Thank you for this, for flying over, first of all, and giving us this opportunity to communicate with your followers. And what I can say about Tickmill is that what really differentiates us from the other brokers is that the founders of the company have had previous trading experience. And when we founded Tickmill, then before that we were actually traders on the financial markets, and we traded primarily futures and futures options with many futures brokers in the world, primarily in the US. And that gave us, and to this day gave us, this understanding of what is it that the traders actually want. And many of our clients, when they have signed up with us, they feel that they are in the place where their counterpart, the broker, the people who are behind this broker, they actually understand, first of all, that it's a very difficult business that they are involved in. I always say that trading is one of the most difficult jobs anybody could have. Coming from myself from this trading industry, and they have found in us people who actually understand this and understand what are exactly their needs, and what we as a broker should focus on. So I think that's really the core underlying reason why we have grown so much, and why we have gathered a huge following, especially among the more professional traders. So I think that's the core principle. So having previous trading experience, knowing what the traders want, and being able to communicate with them in the same language, and of course on top of that, providing the trading conditions that I would say are one of the best in the world. And maybe ending there, that our clients have never any issues with withdrawals or any money transfers. So it's a transparent, understandable, clean brokerage firm that we are running, and I think that's the thing that the clients are appreciating.
And in result, your volumes were growing very, very impressively, right? But there are many voices, you know, saying that the industry is going through some consolidation, that there are some worse times for Forex in Europe in general. And in Tickmill, do you see it also, or you are defending against that?
So what we see is that the industry is in the phase of consolidation, which means that when we founded the company, then there were literally thousands of brokers out there. So we were competing with thousands and thousands of brokers globally. What we are seeing now is that the whole industry is consolidating, which means that most likely a few years from now, if you look at specifically the European space, then there will probably be only 10-15 brokers left. These would be the brokers that are providing multi-asset services, so not only FX, but most likely also other products like exchange-traded financial instruments. They would be very well capitalized companies. Most of them would be publicly listed companies, which would bring a lot of transparency and especially security to the end customers that they are counteracting with solid companies on the other side.
And after ESMA changes, in after ESMA rules restricting leverage and causing this whole consolidation, do you also see negative effect of it on Tickmill? Are you affected somehow by those changes, those rules?
Before ESMA, we were internally discussing that everybody was giving projections how much business we will lose. Shall we lose 50% of the business? Some said we could even lose 70% of the business. What really happened after ESMA was that in terms of the client funds that we have, that clients have trusted with us, so client funds didn't change. And I would say that they have even increased now, so the change took effect in August, we are now in May, so our client funds on the European regulated businesses are 50% higher than what they used to be before ESMA. But what ESMA has done, ESMA changes, is that the volume, the trading volume that average client can generate are in some markets significantly lower, which puts an additional pressure on all the market participants to finding ways how they can increase the business and how they can remain profitable and stay in this business. But adding to that, I must say that for us, European market is just one market. It's of the total trading volume, Europe is less than 25% of our total trading volume. So the ESMA changes, regardless of what they were or what other implications there might be for Tickmill Group as a whole, these changes have not had any effect on us. So we are still growing globally, and we are still growing in Europe as well. So for us, it's been a small shock initially, which has been followed by substantial gains in the market share on a global scale and increase of business and client base. So we are, in that sense, on the good side.
Well, many brokers are now, turning their backs on Europe. They don't see it interesting market anymore from business perspective. They look for business opportunities outside of Europe. Do you think that Europe still is interesting, maybe from your point of view, or is there a chance that trading industry in Europe will thrive again in some years from now?
I think if you look at like the global assets that people are investing into the financial markets, then Europe is after the US, it's the second largest location of assets. So overall, these people still want to trade. And I think what will change in the market is that the brokers are going to look more and more into other asset classes. They will keep the CFD offering and the spot to fix offering what they have today, but they are trying to move more into multi-asset classes and expand their revenue streams so that it would not be only FX and CFDs, but also other products. And after the ESMA, what we have seen on the marketplace is a lot of the European brokers have cut the marketing expenses in general a lot in Europe. Somewhat you could even feel that they have turned their back to Europe. We, on the other hand, have not done it. In fact, we have raised our marketing budgets. We have hired more people in Europe, and we are actually gaining market share in Europe. So we we don't necessarily look the ESMA as a negative influence. We rather look it as a positive influence, giving us the opportunity to expand the market share. So it's not really bad for us.
Yeah, so it turned out it was an opportunity for you actually, right? And so how do you see the future of Tickmill? Is it such optimistic?
I think Tickmill 3 to 5 years from now will be a much different company than it is today, that it is in the eyes of many of our current clients. So for sure, 3 to 5 years from now, we will have more asset classes that we can offer to our clients. We will have more and much sophisticated platforms for our clients. We intend to remain one of the top 20 largest brokers globally in that space. But what we are also looking forward to is to actually expand not only within the brokerage industry, but to expand also outside of the brokerage industry into the wider financial services industry, which could mean payments, banking, asset management, all sorts of these kind of businesses, which in comparison, actually they are not even comparable in terms of the size with the CFD business. So these are hundreds and hundreds of times bigger businesses, industries, that is the FX and CFD business. So we see that we started from this initial phase. We entered the FX CFD industry, and then expanding into other financial services, which possibly in the end will mean that we could be a bank offering A to Z services on a global scale with a very competitive pricing and excellent customer service. So this is our vision, what we want to achieve over the next 3 to 5 years.
I see. So I wish you achieve it, actually.
Thank you very much.